Okay. Camera is rolling. Let's see if we can stuff this in my pocket on my vest here. There we go. Still recording. Yep. Go down in there. Like that. Okay. A little breezy, but the wind keeps dying down and teasing me. So let's find out if we can fly. Okay, check all switches. Here comes something loud taking off out of March. I don't know what this time. Last time was F-22 or F-35. Two of them took off. I can't see nothing out there, but I can hear it. Okay, I think we're still, camera's still rolling. Okay, radio's on. Throttle trim set. Yeah, something's taken off with afterburner. Okay. Sorry about the picture. It's aiming down at the ground momentarily while I plug in my electric starter. Okay. Take off. Let's see here. Engine start throttle. Okay. We had a good flight a couple hours ago. Let's try this again. Let's see, camera's still rolling. Yeah, a little windy, crosswind, but it keeps dying down to zero. When the sun gets blocked by the clouds, then there's a little cloud up there right now. Might be a little lean. It's okay. It'll run. Okay. All right. Wind is looking better. Camera's still rolling, I think. All right. Let's see if we can get anything on film. Start the timer. Set for 10 minutes. Not sure which way to take off here. It's a crosswind. Okay, it's calming down. All right, looking good. Not a good takeoff. I got lucky on that. Full throttle. Yeah, I got lucky. Oh well, we're in the air. Throttle back to cruise power setting here. All right, relax, enjoy the flight. Don't know if I'm gonna get much of anything on video here. I should have used our old crosswind runway for takeoff. Silly me. Taking unnecessary risk with the model. This wind keeps dying down, and then it comes back up, and then it goes cross, and then it dies down, fades away, just teasing me, wants me to take off. Little bumpy down low, yeah, a little turbulent. Yeah, landing's going to be a challenge if the wind keeps up like this. Well, not going to be able to do my competition maneuvers in this kind of wind. Yeah, it's blowing direct 90 degrees now. Eh, well, what are you gonna do? What are you going to do? And the wind just blew my hat off my head. Oh, well. I can't worry about that. Just feel kind of naked without it. The wind was supposed to pick up today like 7 or 8 knots, but it was supposed to blow down the runway from the west this time of day, but it's coming in from the north. So that's not fair. Yeah, not too much fun. Come on, wind, you can do it. You can take a break for a few minutes. Let me fly. Doesn't matter which way I fly the pattern, wind's coming pretty much 90 degrees in my face. Doing a lot of skidding around the turns here. Oh well. 20 minutes ago, it was dead calm for about 10 minutes. I missed my window. I should have been ready to go. Good thing is I got about 18 minutes of flight time on a full tank if I fly at half throttle or less. And I'm just cruising around at half throttle. So if I just loiter for a while, maybe the wind will die down and I'll be able to do some competition maneuvers. Otherwise, we'll just fly around. It all counts, so it doesn't matter. It all adds up to more experience. Of course, the wind is probably messing with the microphone. I'm wearing the clip-on mic because the camera, the cell phone, is stuffed in my pocket. So, and the clip-on mic actually, I think, works a little better in the wind. It's probably a little better insulated. But what do I know? Not much. Magnum 46 with an APC 11.4 and 15% cool power. And let's see, what else? I like the 11.4 prop because the low pitch gives me better gyroscopic maneuvers, higher torque when I need it. And it kind of keeps the plane slow. I don't want it to go blistering fast. I like to fly around slow. And the a 6 or 7 inch pitch just makes it too fast. Even if I fly at 1/3 throttle setting, it's still too fast. So I like this 11.4 APC the best with this engine on this airplane. Right aileron roll, not bad, not bad, considering the left direct crosswind. Wind is dying down, so maybe I'll get lucky. Maybe it'll calm down for landing. I can sneak in. Yeah, it's not a whole lot of fun in this kind of wind. Unless you're flying a glider. You know, if you're on a mountaintop flying a slope glider, then it's a lot of fun. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to have to land on the cross runway there into the wind. That'd be the smart thing to do if I was smart. I got plenty of time. Let's see, I got, timer's almost gonna go off, the 10 minute timer, then I got probably another 7 or 8 minutes after that. So I can loiter and wait. Maybe the wind's starting to shift again. So it's starting to go down the runway. But I still feel it in my face, so it's still coming at me, crosswind. Oh boy, come on, wind, you can do it, you can do it. Just go dead for a while, for a few minutes, and let me enjoy a couple minutes of peace and quiet, and then sneak in and land. Okay, there's my 10 minute timer. So after this, I got about 8 more minutes of fuel at this throttle setting. Trying to avoid flying into the sun. The wind speed is dropping. That's good. That's a good sign. Okay, that's 10 plus 1, 11 minutes total. Wind is decreasing, that's good. Aileron roll to the right, yay! Come back on the power, save fuel. Come on, bring it back around, there you go, don't go that far away. No need to do that. If I have to, I'll come in from the right, like usual, and then make a right turn and land on the cross runway there, into the wind. But we'll see. We'll see how bad it gets down low. Okay, the wind speed is dropping fast, so that's good. That's good. Just barely blowing now. Yeah, the old Sig Smith mini plane, nostalgic model from 1976, I believe, when it was first kitted. Oh, here comes the wind again. See? I should have snuck in when I had the chance. All right, enough of that goofing off. Bring it back around. Come on. There you go. Okay, 10 plus 3, 13 minutes, so I think in the next couple of minutes we ought to plan our landing approach. Gonna be tricky to land it going directly away from me, knowing when to flare. That's gonna be the tricky part. Okay, the wind is calming down. I think I can sneak in. The wind is dropping down to zero. I'm gonna make a landing approach and see what happens. I'll take it. You betcha. Alrighty. That was a 14 minute and 20 second flight, roughly, approximately. Yeah, all right, woohoo, yay! Okay. Turn off the radio here and the, okay, the cockpit, that's off. And transmitter. Okay, there we go. All right. See what the wind is doing now on the pole there. You can see we have not much, but it's coming now from the east, northeast. Yeah. So I might have landed with a little bit of a downwind too. Of course, now it's getting calm again. All right, okay, we can take this video out of the pocket here. And we're still recording, 19 minutes. Okay, we're gonna cut it off in a few minutes here, or a few seconds. I think 20 is long enough. So I'll drain my battery here. And the airplane survived, yay! Yep, all right. Today is April 16th, 2022. I think that was flight number 112 on the Sig Smith Mini. Since I've got it here in 2017 at our September swap meet. And the guy that built it lives over in Menifee. Thank you very much. He gave me a great deal on it and I'm very, very happy with it. Okay, so here we are at Hemet. And there's nobody around, and it's a beautiful day, if you can put up with the crosswind. All right, that's it. It's been 20 minutes, so it's long enough. So, I don't want to flip the, well, let me see here. Oh, hey, there's my hat. Yes. Oh, no. Got all dirty. Chain. Yucky. All right. Bye.